Insan means what? Human being, right? People, human being. So indeed, the human beings, لِرَبِّهِ to his Rabb, to his Lord, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لَكَنُود. كَنُود means what? Talk about yesterday. You guys were sleeping? So what is it? What's the human beings are to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? They are patient, or grateful, or ungrateful? Ungrateful. Right? You guys don't remember? The human beings are ungrateful to Allah. That's what the ayah says. The human beings are what? Ungrateful. Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that about us. We're insane, right? We're human beings. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that we are ungrateful. Human beings are ungrateful. So they have to do something for them to do to be what? To be grateful. If you leave yourself like this, you're ungrateful. Right? Human beings are ungrateful. Unless they do what? Their good deeds, they believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they worship Him alone, right? And they do the good deeds, and they are really from their hearts grateful to Allah. And in their tongue and their actions are grateful to Allah. So I want you to pay attention, because inshallah, if Allah is left, I want to ask you again. Because this is a very serious matter. You know what ungratefulness in the Quran is mentioned in the meaning of what? In the meaning of kufr, in the meaning of disbelief. Because the roots of disbelief is ungratefulness. You know what the roots of something is? Right? Why there is disbelief is because of people being ungrateful. If people are grateful to Allah, they will worship Him alone. But people are being ungrateful. Right? If someone, imagine someone was drowning, right? And he's certain that he's gonna die. Right? Or someone that was in the desert, walked and he's lost. And he's about to die. That's it. He's too thirsty, he's too hungry. And he just submitted himself. He surrendered. He does not have any more energy to walk. Right? So he's just sit there going for death. And then all of a sudden, someone comes to him and rescued him. How happy that person is. Extremely happy, right? Right? He's extremely happy. He saved his life. So how would that person be to the one that saved his life for the rest of his life? Would he be ungrateful to him? Once he saved him, he said, get away from me. I don't want to do nothing with you. Or he would be very grateful to him. He would be very grateful, right? And he would always ask about him. What if that person that saved him asked him to do something for him? Would he, you know, turn him down or something like this? Well, he would be like, as if he's like a slave for the rest of his life. Right? Human beings, they do that, if they have goodness in them, they do that to one another. Right? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nothing is the lack of him. The one that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that keeps us alive now. Right? He's the one that gave you the ability to breathe. Are you guys breathing? Of course you're breathing, because if you're not breathing, you won't be here. Right? So who's the one that allows you to breathe? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Is it me? Is it your parents? Is it anyone else on earth? Who's the one that is allowing you to breathe? What if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take that away from you? Can anybody bring that to you? No. Who's the one that created this air for us to breathe? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided that there's no more air, what's going to happen to us? We'll die. Just one thing, right? I did not mention everything. I just mentioned one thing. Just that one fact that we breathe the air. In and out. Right? Isn't that a great favor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And is it once a week or once a month or once a year you breathe all the air that you want and you stay good, you know, for a year, like a balloon, right? You get a bunch of air and you stay there and then you don't need to breathe the air for... We breathe... How often do we breathe? Exhale and inhale. How long? Second maybe? 1 second? Right? So with every breath we take, that's a great favor, right? with every breath we take. So with every breath we take, we should be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So human beings, you might be grateful to them once in a while. But to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we're supposed to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with every breath we take. Right? Being grateful, being in that state of gratefulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do you understand this? So that means constantly you have to be grateful to Allah. And that's why we need to be, so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestows His favor upon us. How to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with every breath we take? By having this in our heart, by making the obligations, by praying 5 times a day, by staying away from haram, by basically doing what is good, being conscious all the time, thinking, focused, that we're doing things for the sake of Allah, we're seeking rewards from Allah. And as we said yesterday, where's the places where gratefulness is done? You know, some deeds you do it with your hands, with your knees, with your heart only, with your nose, right? But when it comes to shukr, or being grateful to Allah, where is the place where you do it, where you're being grateful? Is it with your hand? With action. But where is the place of gratefulness? That's it. So if I want to be grateful, so I have something in my heart, and that's it. Heart and actions. That means everything in us. Your heart, right? You're grateful in your heart. You see it, you're very sincere, you really mean it. Do you need to be convinced too much to be grateful to Allah? Or it's very obvious? I just gave you the example of breathing, right? Isn't that very obvious? Do you need to give more evidences? Because you're not convinced? Do you need to say, how about the food that you ate today? The fact that you're not hungry, the fact that you're alive, the fact that you have parents, you have food, you have money, you have this, you're a Muslim. This is the best favor ever that you can have. And that is to be guided to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How many people on the face of earth today, they don't know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they don't worship Allah. They believe that He's the one that created them, but they're ungrateful, they're forgetful. They just think that they're living to eat and drink and to enjoy themselves, and that's it. That's it. They don't think of anything. Right? So you should be grateful to Allah that you're worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that you're doing what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created you for. So when the Quran says, إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لِرَبِّهِ لَكَنُودٌ, something that should make you, you know, run away from this. I want to be ungrateful to Allah, like all the human beings. No, I want to be grateful to Allah. How to be grateful to Allah? By following the way of the Prophet ﷺ in our hearts, in our speech, in our actions. So if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you this hand, right, use it in ways that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with you. Don't use it to hit anyone. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not give you hands for this. Right, He gave you hands to use it in good things, right, to be grateful to Allah. If Allah gave you health, use your health for the worship of Allah. Help one another. You know, that's why a Muslim, he would never be helpless when it comes to good deeds. If you have strength and you see that you can help someone in carrying something, this is charity. Right? If you can make remembrance of Allah, time for the salah comes, you make salah, and so on. Okay? Do I need to say more about this? The whole entire life is about being grateful to Allah. So when we recite Surah Al-Adiyat, we should not just recite it because we want to get the recitation correct. We have to change our life by just this one surah. In one verse only. That Allah says that human beings are kind, human beings are ungrateful, they're not grateful. So what do you do when you hear this? Oh, I want to be among these people that are ungrateful to Allah, I want to be grateful to Allah. How to do this? By obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's another verse in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, مَا يَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ بِعَذَابِكُمْ إِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ وَأَمَنْتُمْ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ شَاكِرًا عَلِيمًا. Which means, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would do to punish you, why would He punish you? If you are in shakartu, if you're grateful and you are believers. That means if you're grateful and you are a believer, Allah will punish you. So who are the ones that are being punished? The ones that are not grateful and they're not believers. But when you read the Quran, you see the word shakiran comes before amantum. Ma yaf'al Allahu bi'adabikum in shakartum, which means why would Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punish you? If you are grateful and believers, Which is more important, belief or gratefulness? Belief. The most important thing is belief, right? Belief comes first. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned shakartum, gratefulness first in this verse. You know why? Because as ulama they say, even iman, faith, which is the most important thing, it comes from being grateful. Like say for example, someone is a disbeliever, does not have faith, does not have iman. What makes him believe is the fact that he wants to be grateful to Allah. Because every human being, inside of the hearts, they believe that Allah created them. So a disbeliever, he does not worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's living his life to eat and drink. So now, when he thinks, Allah created me, He provided for me, someone come and invite him to the Tawheed, to La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. He says, yes, I should worship. He's the only one to be worshipped. So because of that, he starts to be grateful to Allah. That would lead them to be mu'min, to be a believer. Right? And the way to strengthen your iman and to make your iman strong is to keep on being grateful to Allah. Okay, so we learn from the surah many things, but one of the very important things is that it's very scary in the surah that human beings are ungrateful to Allah. If you turn the television on, and I do advise you to do that, would you hear the name Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Are human beings talking about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one that created him? Do you find people talking about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, being grateful to Allah? They are saying, Alhamdulillah, Allah give us life. Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, give us the food to eat and the air to breathe. And they're immersed in the favors of Allah. Do you hear people saying Allah is the greatest, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that providing for us? Do you hear this? Why? Because human beings are ungrateful. So what we need to do, we have a mission in this life. We have to be grateful to Allah, we have to call people to be grateful to Allah, we have to show them, we tell them, be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, be grateful to the one that created you. Right? By saying and by believing, and that's why the hadith that we're taking, we took this one, the first sentence yesterday, what's the first sentence that he said? What was the first sentence? At-tahur, shatrun, half of the iman, half of faith, right? And then right after that it says, walhamdulillahi tamla'u al-mizan. Say, walhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah.
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 Tamla'u al-mizan. What's a mizan?
Scale.
Tamla means? Fill. Fill the scale. Scale of what? Scale of good deeds and bad deeds. What is the scale is made of? Not the digital one. What's the, when you think of a scale, what do you think of a scale? Two sides, right? If you put one thing on the other side, to balance it, you have to put equal amount, right? So when you put things on both sides to see who's heavier, which one will be heavier? The one that goes up or the one that goes down? Goes down. Is heavier than the one that goes up, right? Or the seesaw, who's heavier, right? Goes down and the lighter one goes up. So the Prophet ﷺ is saying, Alhamdulillah, tamla' al-mizan. In the Day of Judgment, there's a mizan. There's what? A balance, a scale. In the Day of Judgment, this scale, everything will be on it. First of all, this scale is so huge, as the Prophet ﷺ said, that if the heavens and the earth are put on it, it will still fit. The heavens and the earth. So you can imagine how big that mizan is. Huge, humongous mizan scale. So what's going to be on that scale? Each individual, each one of us, our deeds will be put on that scale. And ourselves even. Right? And our deeds are of two kinds. What are the two types of deeds? Good deeds and bad deeds. So these deeds will be put on the balance, on the scale. The good deeds on one side, and the bad deeds on the other side. Was there anything left? All of the actions, and even the individuals themselves. So if a word that you said, right? If it's something that you did with your face, like, you know, you blinked your eyes to make fun of someone, that's good deed or bad deed? It's there, on the balance. Right? if a person hits someone, it's an event. If you say subhanAllah, if you make your salah, if you're kind to your parents, all of the good deeds will be on the balance, right? So whoever has, whatever is heavier, then he will be saved, right? So the Prophet ﷺ is saying something that would fill your mizan, would fill your scale. And that means that it's going to be heavier, and then you'll be successful. What is it? Alhamdulillah. Can you imagine? Is it that simple? Alhamdulillah fills the scale. What is it? So when you say Alhamdulillah fills your scale, you're done. But that's what the hadith says. Alhamdulillah tamla'u mizan. Alhamdulillah fills the scale. Right? What we were just talking about a few minutes ago, to be what? To be grateful. Right? This is a very important thing for you to be grateful. Alhamdulillah is basically a sign that you are grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Which means all praises to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We're saying Alhamdulillah, that means you're pleased with Allah. That Allah is the most perfect with His names and attributes. You're not complaining when you say Alhamdulillah. Right? When you say Alhamdulillah, that means you're pleased with Allah. That means you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the perfect names and attributes. That fills the mizan and becomes a way of life. And see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most merciful. And for you to remove the bad deeds, so our job is to fill the good deeds on the balance, on the scale, and to remove the bad deeds. Can we remove if I did something yesterday bad that I know that it's going to be on my scale in the day of judgment? What do I do to remove it? I don't want to see it in the day of judgment. What do I do? Am I stuck with it? I have to see it? Or there's a way that I can remove it? If I'm still alive, I can remove it by doing what? Good deeds, but still it will still be there, right? You still, yes, have to do good deeds as well, but one thing that you would do to remove it totally, to make tawbah, to make what? Repentance, to make istighfar, to ask Allah for forgiveness. If you ask Allah for forgiveness, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make it removed. So a person comes in the day of judgment, doesn't see it. That's by the mercy of Allah. So the second sentence of the hadith that we need to learn today, that is related to the surah, for human beings being ungrateful, if you want to be grateful, say Alhamdulillah. Say Alhamdulillah. So say it a lot all the day. All day. How many times after each salah you say Alhamdulillah? 33 times after each salah. Don't rush after the salah, blah, 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 like this. Each one fills the balance, fills the scale, right? Shaitan doesn't want you to be grateful. So be patient after the salah and say subhanAllah 33 times, and they're still coming, what subhanAllah will do, right? And Alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar, you say 33 times and you mean it. So every each salah you say 33 times. Before you go to sleep, you say 33 times. And like this in your free time, say Alhamdulillah and feel it with your heart that you're really grateful to Allah. So that we're not among those who are kanood. You know what kanood means? What kanood means? Ungrateful. What's kanood means, everybody? Ungrateful. So we need to do the opposite, so that we're grateful, and one of which is to say Alhamdulillah. It fills the scale in the day of judgment. Okay, so we learn many things, right? We learn matters of belief, aqidah, in the day of judgment there is mizan. How to fill the mizan, as an example here with Alhamdulillah. There are many things to be said. Alhamdulillah here is mentioned in the hadith, right? And how to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, otherwise people are ungrateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.